Because we're coming to this important part about the programs that we have. So basically we have the four types of programs. It's bachelor, specialist, master's and PhD. And I would like to mention about specialist that this is usually bachelor and master's combined, and this is the degree that is due often in the faculties of natural sciences. Mm-hmm. So yes, all 41 faculties can be grouped in the three big groups, which is natural sciences, humanities, and socio-economic faculties. This QR code and this link down there, I hope that it could be shared with the participants, because this is where you can get the descriptions and links to all programs. I should mention that we have bachelor and specialist programs are mostly in Russian language, but we have 12 master's programs in English. And PhD is usually in Russian, but it can be individually managed because it's a very individual approach. And there are some cases of bilingual programs with some, for example, French universities when it's a double degree program. So let me focus a little bit more on the program. In studying the Russian language. So if you are now graduating from school and thinking of taking a bachelor program and want to study in Russia, we think that it's very important for you to learn the Russian language, because you will speak in your form. So this is a yearly course. It's in Institute of Russian Language and Culture of MSU. Taking this course, you will study language every day. You will live in the dorm and be with other Russian students. You will have a lot of cultural events, a lot of trips during the year. And actually it's amazing, but this yearly course allows students to enter the programs in Russian. And if it's like you feel that a year is not enough, there is an option of studying for 2 years, like advanced level. So this is a really great program, which we really recommend to you. And it has a very nice website that you can visit. You can, you can even still apply for this year, because they're starting online and they're just starting now. And certainly can apply for the next year, because there is no like specific entry requirements other than being a graduate of school. Because this is just a language program, a very intensive language course with living in Russia.
Olga, maybe you can tell us a little bit about the tuition fees of this language program?
Sorry?
About the tuition fees of the Russian language program at Lomonosov University.
Tuition fees? It's it depends very much on, there are like various programs, but like it's between $4,000 and $6,000.
I mean about the tuition fees for the Russian language course, you mean, yeah?
Yes, this is a Russian language course.
Okay.
And but you need to consult the department, of course, to learn, because they work with many agents in different countries, and it can be discounted if you join the program through some agency or something like that.
I got you. Yeah, maybe we can put that maybe in the next webinars or in the coming days we can highlight this more about your partners in different countries in order students to know how to apply and how to
Have some more specific webinar, we can invite colleagues from this department to talk about the program more
Yeah, please, Olga.
Yes, so now moving to master's programs in English. These are the programs I was talking about. So they are in biology, chemistry. This is IT faculty, computational mathematics and cybernetics, and they have a very popular program in advanced computer and networks, because it's conducted together with another big institute in Russia. It's called Tech. It's mm-hmm. very innovative university. So Faculty of Economics, it's very big and very also famous program in within all programs in economics and management in Moscow. This is International Business Management, and it's done with together with the Swedish University. So you can, at the end, you can get a diploma both of Moscow State University and Jönköping.
Jönköping, yeah, it's a famous university in Sweden.
Yeah. And so we have some program in geology. So, I mean, this is also interesting for especially students from some countries where it's, you know, there are companies that work in this field. Yes, so geological, geophysical exploration and modeling. This is a program that offers Innovation Business School. Yes, Faculty of Global Studies. This is probably our most international faculty. Like I said, we recently made this research and they have like, you know, students from 35 different countries in this program. So if you're really interested in international relations and want to make connections while you're studying, then you're welcome to this program. And also I can say the same thing about Faculty of Political Science and their new program, Post-Soviet Policy. This is a very, it's specific, but it's if you're really interested in this in public policy in the region, this is a great program with very international professors, faculty.
Great, great, great.
And Moscow School of Economics, that's our department that is it's like a business school. They have this economics and finance and global economics and finance. Programs with quite a lot of international students.
Nice.
So, yes, you know, for all the tuition fees, they change a little bit every year. So I think we will have the Open Doors Day on 8th November, and probably by that time there will be, you know, at least some indication of the costs. But I would say that it would vary from like $6,500 a year to like $7,500.
That's great. That's great for such as university with such as ranking. I mean, to study with such as tuition fees is something nothing. I mean, it's really a great thing. We need to do that. Tell us more, Olga. What you will do in the 8th of November, you're saying about the opening day. What will happen there?
What will happen on 8th November, it will be all online. Like in my last slide, I will show the link to the website where we're going to do this. So it will be like a big session, first of university management, and then you will be able to join the Zoom session like this, but conducted by the faculty you're interested in. So
yeah, that's great. We need to translate that in our page as well. For sure. Okay. Great.
So a few nice slides about our student life. So this is the total number. It's about 40,000 students in our university, in all its campuses. And here you can see some pictures of our building, of our students. And this is what is important for international students.
Yeah, exactly.
Dormitories. There are quite a few dormitories. This is like on the picture, it's the best one that we have, the newest one. I shall say that, like, you know, that it's not guaranteed that you get a dormitory, but we're really trying to provide to as many, especially freshman students who come in first year to Moscow to study, the dormitory. It's very reasonable price. And it's the convenience is that it's usually located almost on the campus or just on the campus. There are even dormitories in the main building of university, which is an experience to live in the 1953 year building.
So. And what about the tuition fees? Is it expensive to stay in the hostel at your dormitories?
Well, no. It's should be around, you know, the maximum, I think. Let me see. Yes. Well, it will be something like $300 a month at the maximum. So usually it's even cheaper than that.
Yeah, but we are living in the center of Moscow, you know, for such as like thesis, it's so okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
And of course, university has very good facilities for sports, for your hobbies, for whatever you like. It's beautiful green area. Over 1 square kilometer is only the main part of a campus. And yes, these are our sports facilities, and you know, it's also like very nice and very beautiful to.
You know, for me, it was by myself. It was always interesting. You know, the building of MGU, it's a huge one. So the green things and where people can play a football, basketball. It's around the campus itself, the big campus itself.
Yes, it's all around. Campus. Yeah, there. If you're in Moscow, you're welcome to visit, because I will show you around, because it's really around the campus. I'm a graduate of MSU myself, and I remember running like that and seeing the campus and doing all these kind of things.
So it's
very cozy, actually. It's you know, you can see sometimes groups of students just sitting on the grass, like, I don't know, having a little picnic, playing frisbee. Mm-hmm. So we have all these kind of things. And this is our big event, which you are welcome to participate in, especially if you are already a student of a bachelor program, for example. This is an international youth science forum. It's a science conference. This year it was online. I don't know about next year, because it's usually in spring, in April. So we'll see about the situation. But maybe I expect that it will be at least partly online. It's a very big event, and all students can apply, can send a short abstract. And if you're chosen, you can present your research in front of a committee and get a nice diploma, and like some even get some grants from the rector.
Great. This is big, nice. You know, I don't know about the slide. Where is the admission requirements? We will come to that, Olga, right?
Yes, coming to that. Yes, just this nice slide with some student life. Yes, we have over five organizations which are now very much actually helping us, management of university, to work with our international students to make some events for them. So this is just one link that I wanted to show before I come to the admission. This is a portal that we launched, and earlier in the morning I talked about that. This is where you can contact the student hotline if you're already a student, find your buddy. And so international students are really integrated on this portal and really can communicate with their Russian friends, international friends.
Nice. We will highlight these links after our webinar finish. Sure.
Yes. If you can share them to the students, because it's maybe a bit difficult to find on the main website, because there is for international students. And this is, so admission, how to apply for the program. First of all, you can contact us on the website, find the program you're interested in, prepare the documents, and this is the important moment. So I know that international universities collect applications over the year, but here, like, we are at the moment still working, like the admission campaign starts on June 15th. So you can preliminary contact the department you're interested in, but you need to prepare your docs on this date. And register on this website, Web Anketa, and post your documents there. Then you take the entrance exams. The exams are also different, of course, on each program, but usually it's Russian language if it's program in Russian, and will be the specific exam on this program, and it's English language if it's program in English. And Yes, then you just sign the agreement. This year we also do it the process as much online as possible, and you can start to study.
That's great. That's great.
And this is just very important thing. I know that I have to finish. I will probably finish in like 5 minutes. But yeah. Important moments about what documents you need. So you need, of course, a copy of your school certificate or high school diploma. You need copy of your previous degree if you have it. And of course, you need all the things notarized with notarized translations. And eventually you will have to bring the originals, of course. We accept copies on the first stage through this platform, but then you need to have the originals of this document.
Sure, sure.
And of course,
sure.
We have a whole commission that checks all the docs because we have, like, it will be checked on the number of credits, that it's valid, that it's a real, like, complete diploma, not just like 1 year of studies or something like that. So please be very careful if you, especially if you studied, like if you got transferred from a few universities, you know, it often happens, to collect all transcripts you have and to have the official versions of all these documents.
And you know, Olga, I'm getting many questions here about the admission and how things, like, for some questions here about the international curriculum, like IGCSE, SAT, IB, like we have, you know, this, the British high school system, the IB one, the American, the SAT. So we have some questions here because if you know, in most of Arab countries, the Gulf countries like Kuwait, Dubai, Saudi Arabia, many students are graduating from these international schools. So I have some questions here. What is the requirements from these students? Do we have something special for them?
We have not completely integrated with the systems, and we often receive these papers, but we cannot count it as a year of studies, or it's usually like that the student can already go on the second year, but it's at the moment it's not possible just because of Russian legal requirements, because we have a very strict system here. But it all is easier, like you should send your copies of your docs or what you have at the moment to the department, and they will consult, of course, everyone in
To check it again and again. But I'm sure, Olga, we must have, like, maybe in the next week, because we will go ahead, like we start our first webinar session with you, which is a big honor for us, you know, with Lomonosov University, and we will go ahead like every week with a series of webinars. So I believe that we need to go again and again together in order to cover all, like, the big information about Lomonosov University. It's not like fair to have it in one only webinar. So maybe we'll speak in details. We will bring some samples of these documents where you can show us, like, what is the minimum grades of the students must have in the high school diploma in order to be like eligible to apply for Lomonosov University.
Yes, I think it's possible, and we can plan it, and bring our experts to explain more about that.
Great.
Yes, so this is the minimum requirements of the documents that you need. And this is the whole process. The good thing is that dates are basically the same every year. So you need to remember that by like mid of June, you need to have your docs. If you don't, like if you just get your diploma this year, you still need the transcript and some paper from your school confirming that you will get your official diploma by certain date. And you upload photocopies, and then there will be a few waves, but like biggest wave is usually the exams take place sometime in the middle of July. So by beginning of August, you usually already know if you're enrolled. And if you kind of were hesitating or trying to apply somewhere else, you still have a chance. In August, it's usually the second wave of examinations not maybe all, but at some departments they always do it, especially for foreign students. And yes, then you sign the contract, and semester always starts on 1st September. It's a big holiday here. So by September, you certainly will already know if you're enrolled.
You are accepted or not. Yeah, hopefully that most of our students watching us here will be accepted when they will apply to Lomonosov.
Yes.
Yeah, but they must know, I'm sure that they must know before in advance, like what is the minimum requirements, how to apply, how to prepare their files in order to be processed very fast. Yeah, Olga, what do you have else to add for us today?
Yes, well, I mean, today I do not have like very detailed presentation about that. As we discussed, we will maybe
Sure, we will
arrange
launch, we will
another
have
webinar.
more webinar sessions for sure, for
Yes.
sure.
So, but like at the moment, what you can do, you can already go to this open day msu.ru. There is Russian version and English version of this website, and check everything. And you can also write us a question, like put through this website or on this email admission at rector@msu.ru, and ask your questions.
And once again, in 8th of November, when you're saying about the Lomonosov Open Day, it will be in English or in Russian only?
Well, this yes, here I'm coming to the open door day. It will be there will be session in Russian and session in English. And then
Regular.
depending on the program you're interested in, you will either have it in Russian or in English.
Yeah, in case if they have it in English, I go to, I
Yeah, we
go
even
to.
had it in Chinese actually, because we have a lot of students in China from China.
Yeah.
So yes, we have a little session in Chinese language, and also students could ask questions in Chinese language.
Great, great, great. See, we have some Chinese with us in the live right now. So Chinese friends, you can speak in your mother language. That's great. That's great.
Yes.
That's great.
So you're very welcome to join our Open Doors Day. We will open registration in like beginning of October. We just today learned about the date, so it's all
That's
being
good.
arranged. And I hope that yes, we can cooperate and share information about it through your
For
Instagram.
sure, for sure, for sure. Olga, thank you. Thank you very much for your time, for the whole effort what you've done. I'm see you sharing the contact with us here about students, what they need to do. Just like send email to admission at rector.mcu.ru,
Yes.
or they can use the what you're showing us here, Olga. They can use something else.
Yes, let me just show you the how this website looks. I think it will be good. Just a second. Yes, so now if we go to this. Yes, this is how it looks. This is open day msu.ru m. And this is very, and there is this send a preliminary application option. It's not an actual application, but this is your request, your inquiry to a certain program. So here you choose like what you're interested in, what you're applying to. Like you can write your questions, and we will answer you at the earliest convenience. So we'll transfer these questions to the person in charge.
Great.
And here you can also like get some insight, see the virtual tour of our university, get like some information about these programs. And there are links to programs. Here is like a lot of programs in Russian, so you can get a whole details about each program. We prepared it for the, for our previous open doors, so now we have all the collection of
Yeah,
information.
big work, guys, waiting for you. Nice.
Yes, so guys, you can you're very welcome to just look through this website and ask a question or send an application through this because it's just a little bit easier for us to collect it. But if you just write to admissions, we will also of course see your inquiries.
Sure. Olga, you start your presentation today talking about space programs. And you know, our country, Russia, it's one of the leading countries worldwide with the space industry. And we would like to have like more to talk more about this space program. Maybe in our next webinars, we will send invitation to students in advance about our next webinars. Maybe it will be next week or after a couple, maybe 2 weeks max. But we need to be in touch more and more, because we have really many interested students asking our questions, giving like from Chinese, I'm seeing here, from Middle East guys talking in Arabic here. So guys, we are sorry, really, we cannot host like all our your questions to answer it at the moment. But Olga, she promised us that she will be with us for in the next week and the next webinar sessions to talk more and in more deep things about Lomonosov University. the top university in Russia, the like one of the most beautiful, biggest, like nice universities in Moscow. You see to the building, it's something like just wow. So Olga, thank you very much. Thank you very much for your time, for the effort you've done for us to be here today with us, to give opportunity for international students to listen from you guys, like in direct. And all that we're preparing for our virtual fair, which will be in 22nd, 23rd of October, and Lomonosov University will be a part of this virtual fair, where all students will be able to chat directly with Olga and to listen to Olga's seminars again and again to answer all their questions. So Olga, thank you very much for your time. Thank you.
Thank you for providing this opportunity and this platform. And yes, I hope we will prepare for the future webinars and for the big fair, because it's also very important and interesting for us to get in touch directly with our prospective students.
Great.
So goodbye, everyone. And if there are some questions, you can, if you can send me the like contacts of these people, we can arrange that we answer them.
Sure. We will be sharing a database with you with all their contacts, and for sure we'll keep it for you.
Okay,
Olga. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye-bye.